Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, you're going to learn how to put an image inside of text in Photoshop. We will use this document that contains three layers: a background layer, a text layer, and an image. The font and size are not relevant for this technique. You can use any font or size that you like. You can even use a vector shape or another pixel layer. To place an image inside of text in Photoshop, you can use a clipping mask. A clipping mask lets you use the content of a layer to control the visibility of the layers above. So the shape of the text will control the visibility of the photo. To create a clipping mask, simply select the image, which is above the text layer, and press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows. That's Command-Option-G on the Mac. Notice how the layer thumbnail is then indented to the right, and a down-pointing arrow appears next to it. The layer controlling the visibility is then underlined. You can have multiple clip layers, but in this case, we only need one. The best thing about using clipping masks to put an image into text in Photoshop is that the text remains editable, and you can change it at any time. If you want to reveal an additional area of your photo to make it seem as if it's coming out of the text, you will need to duplicate the layer by pressing Ctrl-J. That's Command-J on the Mac. Then, make a selection out of the area that you want to reveal. In this case, I will use the Quick Selection tool, and I'll click and drag to select the arm. Then you can click on the layer mask icon to create a mask, revealing only the contents of that selection and hiding everything else, making it seem as if the arm is coming out of the text. You can, of course, spend more time fine-tuning the mask, but for this tutorial, this mask will work. If you want to give the text a shadow and a bevel to make it stand out, we can use layer styles. But you must understand how layer stacks affect the look of the layer style. Otherwise, you could run into problems. For example, to add a bevel, you can double click on the side of the text layer to bring up the layer style window. Then you can click on Bevel and Emboss to apply the bevel, which gives the text layer shape and dimension. You can use any settings that you like, but these settings are fine for this project. Now, let me show you a problem that arises when you try to apply a shadow to the text. Notice that the shadow looks great on the text, but there is no shadow coming out of the arm. So I'll disable the shadow and press OK. To add a shadow to all the layers at the same time, hold Shift and click on the topmost layer and click on the text layer to select them all. Then press Ctrl-G on Windows, Command-G on the Mac to put those layers into a layer group. You can now double click on the side of the group to bring up the layer style window, and you can apply a layer style to all the layers in the group as if they were one single layer. So when you enable the shadow, you will see that it applies the shadow to both the text and the arm at the same time. If you want to learn more quick tips on using type in Photoshop, check out my 90-second tip on using the knockout technique to create non-destructive masks. I'll place a link right below in the description. Don't forget to click on that subscribe button and on the notification bell so that you don't miss any new tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again in the next Photoshop tutorial.